All right, everybody. Welcome to 24 Slayton. I'm Tim. I got Dave and Jordan. Dave's back, everybody. Dave's back.
That's crazy.
How's that?
Yes.
The other Dave.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
There's Black Dave. Yeah. So yeah. I know that Dave didn't... Yeah. He's a little concerned about that, but there's Black Dave right here.
All right. So what's happening, Dave? How you been?
Pretty good. Pretty good, guys. Just hanging out.
Trying to avoid us? Trying to avoid us? Avoid us?
No. Not yeah, avoiding.
He was. He was scared.
Been busy.
Oh, scared.
Been
scared.
Busy. Motoing. Having a good time.
Motoing.
Yeah, dude.
Cap. He's capping.
Nope.
Well, he's motoed, what, three times?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's killing it now.
Yeah, killing it.
It's better than not going, because he was not. He was the not go guy for a while.
That's true.
That is sad. Also, the not podcast guy.
Yes. You know what? He just cut everything out.
I had to. It was work. Work related.
Work. Okay.
Right. Working. I like it. Huh? Working.
So, George.
Yes.
What's happening? What have you been doing?
I was sick.
Again?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was sick for like 2 weeks. That's why I wasn't on the podcast.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, he was a sick guy. He had the new one.
Oh, yeah, man.
He had to be all extra.
I had RSF.
Yeah.
Or RSV. Yeah, I think it was RSV.
Yeah, he's being special.
Jeez.
Yeah.
Where are you going? Where are you hanging out?
Dude, he doesn't go nowhere.
I don't.
I'm kind of lost right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, like, I don't.
But it has
I don't
to be his out. Uber. Has to be his Uber delivery drivers.
Probably. Damn.
Yeah, that's it. He gets Uber food and then Uber sicked.
That's pretty cold one.
I had to get at a Smash event. It was their fault. I got sick on a Wednesday, so it had to be from the Tuesday.
Tuesdays and Wednesdays.
Or it could have been the weekend incubation period.
I don't have friends that I'm going to be out on the weekend.
Oh, I don't know. Dang, man, don't put yourself down like that. You got friends. We're here for you.
No, he's my dad.
Yeah, I know. You got friends, and, too, you know.
And just you're one Dave, away. And you've been avoiding us.
I've been avoiding you.
That's why I got sick. You haven't been there.
I guess so. Yeah. All right.
Oh, man. I don't know if we had any requests for you to come back, Dave.
Oh, that's good. I have no requests. We're good. That means I'm doing it right.
No, we need a request to get you back here.
Yeah.
Hey, I mean, you're still part of us, but, you know, you just been...
Working, man.
Working. He does not work all the time.
Yes, I do.
He went to Paula the other day. You know where Paula's at, everybody? Paula Casino? It's like 2 hours away from here. And he's like, oh, it's not that far.
Yeah, it's not. So it's good. It's a nice little short little drive from Walnut.
Yeah, Walnut. That's what...
Nuts. Walnut.
Nuts. So, what do you think, Dave? What are we going to talk about? What are we going to talk about today?
Honestly, what's been on the top of my head is what makes a good movie? For your favorite movie?
What makes a good movie?
Or your favorite movie.
Or my favorite movie.
Yeah.
So that's obvious. That's easy for you.
Easy for me.
Yeah, it's super easy.
I don't know why, but I have four favorite movies.
So, let's go down the list.
Okay, four favorites. Let's go with Friday. Gladiator, 8 Mile, and Pretty Woman.
That's it.
We're good.
Well,
I can watch those all the time.
Has there ever been a movie that topped those though? Like just it not, been, not favorite, but it was good.
It would have been in my favorites.
Oh, okay, sure. Fair enough. That's true.
If it's better than the other ones, then it just knocks one of them down. Then it would have been five.
What about Napoleon Dynamite?
Napoleon Dynamite's cool.
Mm-hmm. But it's not on the list.
No. Austin Powers, not on the list. That's
ooh,
good.
The Austin Powers is...
Yeah, they were good.
Wait,
they were
hold
good.
On. Austin Powers might be, because you quote a lot of Austin Powers. I feel like...
It was good, but it's not on the list. Okay. You know what? I could put Elf on the list almost.
You could put Elf?
Yes, nope. I could put Elf on the list.
Worst movie of all time.
You're wrong. You're just wrong. But, no, what about... While It Was Immortal?
Yeah. That's not one of my... That's a good movie.
Yeah.
It's not my favorite.
Okay. So, why do those four movies?
I just like them. Like, I can watch them over, and I don't know why, but they come on, and let's watch it again. Look, Jordan, look what I'm watching.
Yeah, he texts me,
so bad.
I'm watching it's Gladiator right now.
I'm stuck. I got roped in. It's on TV.
I got to watch the whole thing now.
Yeah, I watch it. And I know what's going to happen.
And he can say all the words.
Yes.
All the words to all those movies. Actually, really, for Pretty Woman?
Pretty much all of them, yeah.
Word. I outside, like, I see you use all those other movies.
Because we haven't had a chance for me to use a Pretty Woman word quote. Quote.
Okay, well, what's your favorite Pretty Woman quote? Because you got easy for Gladiator.
No, I have. I just know them. I don't know. I don't.
Coming
I
can't down put them on the street. Is that
movie? Yeah, that movie. That oh. movie.
Yeah. So that song is actually from that movie?
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yeah, science.
And that doesn't even figure context.
It doesn't even figure context. I didn't know that that song was made for that movie. I didn't know that. Mm. I thought it was just a general song that came out in like the 50s.
Hold on, everybody. Good looking out, Tom. Fast House.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, thank you very much,
thank
Tom.
You. Thank you, everybody. Hopefully we get a sponsorship by Fast House. You know,
that'd be cool. It
can work. I think I need to get faster to get sponsored by Fast House.
I'm just looking at this.
Oh, all right.
See? Like, we can... They're here. This is in the way. Here, let me see. There, Fast House. There you go. Yeah, I can see it. You guys can see it. Okay, anyways, Fast House. It's a gear company. No, I wear.
Yep.
Dave kind of cheats every once in a while, but I keep it on. I keep it 100. So, go ahead.
What's up?
Tell what
us
about yours?
Tell us some of your horrible movies.
A horrible?
Because you don't like...
You already disrespected my list.
You already disrespected Elf.
Yeah, you...
Okay, Elf is just... I can't do it. Sorry, guys. Sorry to the fans watching. I just...
We're also... By the way, as of recording, we are near Christmas.
Yeah, and...
That
and
movie...
Now Dave's gonna listen. Dave is all traditional. With yeah. the worst movie ever. Go ahead. Tell us your traditional movie. Tell us your traditional horrible movie.
My all-time favorite movie still was Backdraft.
Okay.
Yeah, that movie's dope.
Because it's science.
I've never seen it.
Because it's science, huh?
Dude, how could you? No.
Because it's science.
There's a little bit of science in there.
There's a lot of science. That's what it's about.
But I would say Backdraft.
Because you want to be a fireman?
I did at one point. Can't. That's an asthma. There's a whole other subject.
Okay. You can do anything you want.
True, but yeah. Smoke inhalation and need an inhaler doesn't work out together.
They have tons of oxygen. Go ahead. But anyways, you can do whatever you want. You can do whatever you want. Go ahead.
So yeah.
Just like he doesn't have friends, you can do whatever you want.
So Backdraft, number one for me still. Second is gonna be
Lord of the Rings.
No, not Lord of the Rings.
Not there. Granted, I just binged watched it, or like really? This year.
He's binge watcher guy.
Oh man, yeah. Is this the first time I ever seen Lord of the Rings?
No, like from beginning to end. Oh, like, okay. I've seen them all, but like out of order, and like it didn't have as much context until I watched it from beginning to end. And it's like, I liked it.
Okay,
I know we're gonna talk about today too. Go ahead, I got something on my mind.
Okay, yeah. Apollo 13. Okay. I like that with Tom Hanks and surviving in space. That shit's tight.
Fake news. Science.
Yeah, see?
You're all about science. You're all about science.
So
Backdraft and Apollo, okay.
What about Matrix?
Matrix
is
good.
That's kind of science.
It's not my favorite.
That's not science.
Yeah.
It's computer science.
No,
it's not really. That's just...
It's more of a philosophical thing.
Yeah.
True.
Okay, what else?
Let's see where we go with that. Oh, what is it? The movie Juice?
Juice.
Yeah.
You got the juice.
Yeah.
Because Tupac?
Yeah. No, it's not because
of Omar?
No, just the way it goes. It's just like, I like that.
Oh, you know what? Go ahead.
Yeah, I think one of your favorite movies is Boys in the Hood.
It's cool. Boys in the Hood, yeah, it could be one of my favorite. Another one of my favorite movies is Paid in Full.
That's where I was going to go. I was going to say one of them because I've watched Paid in Full over 10 times.
Paid in Full.
Seriously. Like,
just 10 times?
No, more than that. Just,
okay.
That's just a basis.
Did that in a week. Okay, go ahead. Yeah, Paid in Full.
Okay.
When they start going?
Yeah.
With, what's the name of the wheelies?
With the wheelies?
Yes.
Oh, on the street bike?
Yes. Huh? Crazy.
Camera.
Huh? With the Dougie? Can't hit him with the Dougie? Come on, B. Come on, B. I got him with the Dougie, B.
Oh, man.
See? You've seen it, too. You know the movie, but you're just not...
Yeah, it's not registering right now. But as soon as I see the movie, I'll...
Yeah.
That happens a lot, actually.
What you need, B? Got your back, B. There, B. Huh? Anything you need, B, let me know. It's a New York thing. New York thing. New That's York. Why. That's,
yeah, yeah. That.
Paid in Full is New York.
Yeah, real New York.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
That's it?
Oh, no. I still got one more.
One more? You have as many as you want.
Oh, Right. Oh, I thought we were kind of capping at four. I think you only did four or five.
I mean, there's a lot of movies. We can go. I could be here till.
In that case, so it's going from, we're going to go from Juice to, damn, there's nothing.
Paid to Full.
No. Wolf of Wall Street.
Wolf of Wall Street.
Yeah. Really? Yeah, dude, I watched that movie way too many times. Like
fantasizing. Think, man.
Man,
you know, I gotta get in the.
Yeah, I like get being into, rich.
You know, I can get into this.
He likes to fall for a white devil.
He thinks that he can make a lot of money on the stock market.
Yeah, legally, not illegally, like him.
Might just if you do it illegally, just stop early. Just stop. Don't get juiced. Don't get greedy, and that's what happens.
And then
sponsor.
I'll round it out so it's not
sponsor plug. Go ahead.
Let's see. There's so many, man. Just going through. To round it out, Cal top five, I'll say Ladder 49. That's a good one.
Ladder 49.
Yeah, that's another fire.
Who was that? Ethan Hawke? No, who was that?
John Travolta's in it.
He was the captain.
The
obvious.
What's his name? Joaquin Phoenix is the main actor.
Dude, Joaquin.
Gladiator.
Yes.
Is he in Gladiator?
Yeah.
Oh my God, stop it.
I only know Russell Crowe in Gladiator, right?
Dude. Yeah, the antagonist.
Oh, the antagonist, yeah. Thank you. That's all I needed. Yes. No, I forgot about that scene.
Am I not merciful?
Yes.
Bang.
Am I not merciful?
All right, Jeremy. Where are you at with your top five? You can't just throw Lord of the Rings in there either because you just saw it.
No, on the real, it'd probably be Star Wars. I love Star Wars. I have everything from 1 to 6, I love Star Wars. 1 to 6, I cannot do the other ones. Oh, I like Rogue One too, but I'm probably anything Star Wars, I kind of obsess over it.
This conversation will go nerd quick.
That's really nerd for me. I'm going to keep it a buck. That's probably my nerd pleasure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
What else do I like? Honestly, I like pretty stupid movies, too. I really like... I think I like... It'd be a toss-up between, Napoleon Dynamite or Nacho Libre.
Oh, dude, another one that I fucking hate. I can't stand Nacho Libre. I'm so sorry.
Dude, you just don't... having fun.
Elf and Nacho Libre are literally in, my... top five of hated movies. I can't do it, dude.
You don't like fun. That's what it is.
Nacho!
David I have a buddy hates fun.
Who dresses like Nacho Libre for Halloween.
Fantastic.
And he loves Nacho Libre. And I saw the movie in the theaters with my grandma and my brother again. Elf is the same, and I can't stand both of those movies. There's good memories with those two, but...
I think you just don't want to like it because...
No, it's not that. I've tried. I tried to watch it neutral. And it just started frustrating me. Stop. It's weird, man. I don't know. It did not hit my funny bone.
What about Napoleon Dynamite, then?
Oh, I like Napoleon Dynamite.
How do you like that one? And you like the other ones? That's stupid. They're stupid. And then Napoleon Dynamite just went through the roof on stupid. Right.
Guilty pleasure movie that I laugh at regardless.
Regardlessly,
stupidly all the time, is actually that movie, Napoleon Dynamite. I don't know why. And
come on, Tina.
Fucking
well, get your phone,
Tina.
Can I get some tots?
Give me your tots.
That's not gonna stop.
Give me your tots.
That's funny. Malibu's Most Wanted. That movie.
That fits.
That movie cracks me up.
That fits.
There's just so many things in there.
I think Napoleon Dynamite has to be there because I quote it so much.
That fits. Malibu.
Malibu's Most Wanted.
Malibu.
That fits. We got it now. Now we figured it out. I figured a lot of it out now. Okay, go ahead. Oh. Jordan.
I had another movie in that I was thinking of and I lost it. I gotta think of it.
Maybe Star Wars 1 through 6.
What's the guy's name from Rick Kundo? What is his name?
I like Pulp Fiction.
I like Pulp Fiction too. That could be one of my favorites. That's five.
Pulp Fiction. Yeah, Pulp Fiction.
That's a good movie.
Pulp Fiction is so good.
That's because I like to do drugs so much. It just puts me in that same thing.
I don't think that's the reason.
I think I live vicariously through them.
That's because I do drugs and then alcohol, and I just relate to it.
And you also get.
Yes.
You get, yeah.
Oh, you have a Royale with cheese?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Say what again? Say what again?
That's a does he movie. Look like a bitch? Fantastic
yes.
movie.
Yes, that's great. That's like a good quoting movie.
Yeah, I feel like my favorite movies are the ones that I probably quote the most. Or like, you know, Boys in the Hood. Who dis? I say that all the time. Why you gotta act like your daddy?
No. Who answers the phone like that? Here's mama. Who dis? I don't do that, though. I'm sorry.
But my mom always talk about how I act like
your daddy.
Like oh, man.
Poor Jordan. Yeah. Okay, so.
Yeah.
Where else are you going? I think, like, I don't see how Friday, I quote
yeah,
Friday.
Yeah, I think, I know I'm so much pretty Friday. Sure Friday is actually just on there, too. Yeah, I can say Friday quotes all the time. From Friday and next Friday.
And yeah. Friday after next.
Yeah.
Pinky. I think I sent that one for Christmas. That was a Christmas card to everybody. Yeah. It's pink. When he comes inside the house, I got this one for you.
Hmm? Do I have to slap a bitch?
What was her name?
Hmm?
What was her name?
Her name for...
The girl Pinky Butt for Craig. Craig.
Oh, that's in Friday After Next. I forget her name from that one.
I forgot.
Threw me off because I was thinking, I started thinking of Day-Day quotes.
He's in there. Going,
yeah.
He's in there.
Yeah, he's in that one too, but...
Oh, man, I have to when it broke. Huh?
Yeah.
It's not Juicy. Mouth did. It's not Juicy,
Juicy
right?
Mouth did.
Because he sings a song. Candy. Candy.
Oh, Candy.
Covered California is making health insurance.
Candy. I think it's Candy.
Candy.
Right?
Yeah, it is. I'm pretty sure it's Candy.
Good. Don't have to look at this. Sorry, everybody, for that mistake.
You can edit that out.
I don't want to edit it out. Edit it out. I'm going to leave it in. It's a mistake. Okay. We're just flowing. We messing up because Dave's back.
Oh, yeah, we're a little back to our roots. Back to our roots and just make mistakes.
Like the. That's what I want, Jordan. Did you put that in the bag that you got me?
No.
That's not what I got?
No.
Damn it. Dude. You know what I got? You know what this is? This right here? Seriously? I asked for this. This is what I asked for. For Christmas. You know what I got? For Christmas. This is pre-job Jordan.
Pre-job Jordan.
It was nice. I liked it. I liked it. It was cool. It was really like, I wanted it. I got it. And then after this, the job Jordan, top, all times greatest.
Okay. Oh, the first job, first present I got for him with the job.
Best present.
The bidet.
Ever.
Oh. Best present. Nice. Ever.
But.
Okay, so where are we at? We got, where, what else you got? You have to have something else. Hey, Brian, what's your favorite movie? No, you're watching. Wesley? I know you guys are watching, so what's your favorite movie?
Actually, hit us
down there.
Please hit us with the comments of your favorite movies. But, ooh, I saw that. I kind of really like Squid Game.
Isn't that more of a series, though?
No. It's,
wasn't
it one series? Oh, it is a series.
Yeah. Serious. Serious.
Frank.
It's a series.
That's another issue. I've been watching way too
many. Okay, well
series.
Let's go. We'll go to series after. Series after.
We're gonna go forever for that one.
Yeah, I was just gonna say right now. Yeah, science. You guys know where that's at.
Just Breaking Bad.
Yeah, dude, that's my all-time number one right there.
Really?
Yeah, for series.
Okay.
TV show series, completely.
That one's hard too. I'm pretty sure my number one.
We're not there yet.
I know, but like, okay. But like the movies, it's still. Like, what other movie have I watched?
The Notebook. Say I'm a Bird.
I've never seen Notebook.
Say I'm a Bird.
I've never seen that.
I did. I used to watch it. Didn't really want to watch it, but I had to watch it. Sam, a bird. You like Titanic.
I didn't no. like it.
When I was younger, I liked that movie, oh. Titanic.
Low-key?
Low-key.
Lion King.
Lion King. What about your favorite movie?
Dude, I had a...
You want to know what Jordan's favorite movie was? I could seriously sit him down and watch it for over and over and over. Back to back to back to back.
Oh,
to back.
Actually, Shrek.
Babe.
Babe? Dude, honestly...
I watched it Babe? The other day. I watched it the other day. Mm-hmm. Babe again. And I was like, that's why Jordan liked it.
Oh, if we're going
come
to...
On, come on, Pig.
I forget.
That'll do. That'll do. That'll, you know why? Because it's Jordan's roots. That's what happened. Yeah. He started thinking of it. Like, oh, yeah. That'll do, Pig.
That'll do, Pig.
My favorite as a child, I could watch all over, even now as an adult, I could still watch it. I watched it recently. Was
Jersey Shore?
No, The Great Mouse Detective.
Great Mouse Detective.
Yeah.
Okay, well, anyways. Babe, dude. Babe.
Oh, Jordan, actually, Jordan was all no, babe. No, I know what my favorite cartoon is. Emperor's New Groove.
Did we move to cartoons?
No, well, no, it's one of my favorite movies. Like, okay. Because, like, as a cartoon, it's still a movie.
Something's really bothering me, Jordan.
Yeah.
Right here? There's a hair. Thank you.
So OCD.
Yeah, because it was right there.
All
right. Okay. We're good now, everybody.
Emperor's New Groove.
I can.
I remember you guys seeing that, too.
It's
because he was naked. Jordan likes naked. Right. Oh, that's Emperor's New Clothes.
Yeah.
Oh, my bad.
Yeah, Emperor's New Groove is like, it's got David Spade.
Okay.
Doing the voice.
Different than the clothes. Because the Emperor's New Clothes were something else. Okay, anyways, go ahead. Where else were we at?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's your last one? I don't think you said one.
No, I think that's my five.
Oh, okay.
That's like, your five.
Yeah.
That's your five?
Yeah.
Okay, got five on it.
Got five on it. Because if we also go on a music...
No, we already did that.
Oh, yeah.
Dave wasn't here, though.
Oh, yeah.
He was going to go in death metal or something.
Yeah.
Underground. Death metal.
Wasn't even underground, man.
His favorite day is Avenged Sevenfold.
No, the fuck it isn't. No, I'm not a Avenged Sevenfold fan.
Oh, my God,
dude. Don't get into it. If we go down that rabbit hole, it's going to get deep.
Okay, George, I have a question real quick.
Yeah.
Before we go on to something else.
Yeah.
We were driving. We went a long journey yesterday.
Yeah.
To go riding, to go visit Fred. Mm-hmm. I hope you're watching, Fred, because if you're not, I'm not going to visit you again. So, we're driving, and I think we talked about it. He's talking about the anime characters on the car.
Yeah, what is that, dude?
What anime characters?
Dude, I've been seeing
the people that put the anime characters on the car?
All around the car, the girls with the boobs and all that shit.
The wraps?
Yeah, what's
no, up? Not just the wraps. They have on the window.
Stickers.
They stick on the window. But they have the car thing. They have all that
stuff.
It's
just degen culture.
What?
Degen culture.
Okay.
Degenerates.
So we asked this, what? And you're saying degen, explain.
Explain.
Okay.
Explain, please.
Pause though. There's degen music, and then there's degen culture.
Yeah.
Because I know about degen metal music, but not the degen culture speak.
No. Look it up. See it?
Okay.
He signed you off.
Yeah, because that's not even degen. Like you want.
Is it DGENT?
No, DGEN.
Okay, then yeah, they're completely separate.
Yeah, like DGEN.
I'm not sure, but I'm not gonna say it. But I think Dumb Generation. That's not it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Yeah,
it's try not to.
It's degenerates, mm-hmm. where they just got like. It's like. Degenerates and like weeb culture, like there's a whole.
Oh yeah, weebs.
What the fuck is that? I don't know.
Anything. Oh, weeaboo is.
He's gonna teach you.
Yeah.
Teach him.
A weeaboo is someone who is obsessed with Japanese culture, although they are Western.
Okay.
Kind of like Jordan. Jordan's obsessed with.
What about Japanese the flip culture. Side of that? The Japanese culture that is obsessed with Chicano culture.
Those are called vestibules.
Mm, okay.
Yeah. That is loud, dude.
Yeah.
Hold on.
This I'm gonna cut out. Okay, yeah, because I heard that. It's like just thundering outside all of a sudden. I don't know what the hell's happening.
You know what? I'm gonna leave it in. Don't worry about it, people. I just have my AC went on, and it's really loud. So I'm gonna turn it off.
Yeah, we gotta be hot. Yeah.
All right, there. I'll just leave it in. I don't care.
We have a culture. It's like people who are obsessed with Japanese culture, even though they are from the West.
Okay. Yeah. How far is considered West? Does it start with, like, Europe?
Yeah, it starts with Europe.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. But why are we West?
Technically, we'd be far East Coast.
We can get really into that one.
That's why I know why we're West. They're only right there.
Yeah.
We can be East. Oh, it's because of the flat Earth map.
Yeah, flat Earth map.
The flat Earth map.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, shit. That's...
Because we're in the Western Hemisphere. I don't know why, like, Europe is part of the West, though. If we're in the Western Hemisphere, because they're still in the Eastern Hemisphere.
I don't know. But no, because they're in the west of us, which is across the Pacific.
Mm-hmm.
But so maybe they're not.
Japan's more...
Maybe... Eric! You want to talk about it? Huh? Let me know why we're the East Coast. You should know this because you're
We're the West.
This guy. You're this guy, Eric. Coast. You're this guy. You're this guy, Eric. Earth. He's not this guy. He's not this guy.
Round.
This me.
He's not this guy. Eric's this guy. So, oh yeah, okay. Finish up. So what's the differences in the pictures and the...
Yeah, with the DJ culture on the car.
Well, it's just like usually based off their, like, they probably have pictures of their waifu.
Really?
Yeah.
Yes.
Waifu.
So that's why they put it on the outside of their car, let everybody else know?
Because they're obsessed with the character.
So, mental institution.
There are a lot of people who idolize their favorite anime character so much that they legitimately think that is their girlfriend.
Wow. Yeah. I didn't know that.
And there's actually a Japanese guy that has married a 3D model of his 2D girlfriend.
Hey, everybody. Mental institution. The AC went off finally.
Yeah. Dude, so, you know, that makes me, like, wonder about the cosplay girls.
Yeah.
And how dangerous that shit has to be then.
Oh, you would not believe how much money those women make.
Oh, insane. The one chick who's not waifu or whatever, sold bathwater, wasn't she part of that culture?
She's different. She wasn't part of she didn't do like the cosplays, but she had her own simp culture.
Dude, that's
incredible. And oh my gosh, what was her name? She's a genius.
The one that starts with a C from England?
Yeah. No.
She has the things right here, the temples?
Yeah.
She knows where's...
Oh, man, what's her name?
Cassidy? No.
I don't know, but that's...
It's not Casey Tron. Tron was the first streamer to, like, show off. And,
Isn't that... Hold on. Pause.
Yeah.
What's up with you in this? Pause.
Yeah, pause, because I'm thinking of something else. The streamer chick, does that have to do with the e-girl aesthetic too?
Yes, like Pokemon and or Amaranth.
Yeah. That's what I was wondering about. That's why I said pause, because it made me think of that. And
we can just keep going. You don't have to. We can just keep moving around. We're still on the subject, and there's so many things.
We were still on the subject. I can't remember her name. It's gonna bug me. I can't even look at my phone.
Who am I looking for?
Just put in who sold bathwater.
Dude, so what the hell is going on with that culture? I'm so lost.
Like simp culture?
Yeah. Where does it reside on the internet and shit like that? Like
OnlyFans.
Oh,
honestly, like that one chick was the reason why OnlyFans blew up.
Uh-huh.
It's because she made it popular. Like, she couldn't get the money off Patreon because her content
Belle
is...
Belle Delphine. That's the one I was talking about, too.
Yeah, Belle Delphine is...
She's in one of those things. Like,
yeah, she's a genius. Like, she's crazy, but she's that's probably what makes her a genius.
She's from England.
So do they put her on the cars, too?
No, I don't think so. No. She's just a person. She's not an anime character.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But, like, there are girls that dress up as anime characters, and they make money. And there's girls that dress up as anime characters and then do porn, and they make so much money.
You should do that, Dave.
Dress up. I'm going to do a big black guy.
Yeah, dude, no. They're legit. You could legitimately do a cosplay as a big black guy doing one of these girls, making money.
There you go. I didn't say that. My wife I didn't say that. She won't know. Well, she don't know one heard her. And if you're bringing the money, that way you don't have to go to Tennessee.
True.
That way you don't have to go to Tennessee. You're paid. Yeah. Paid.
That's wild.
Gabby's probably like, it's not going to work.
Money.
Four minutes a minute.
Tops. She didn't say so.
She's like, 3 minutes tops? Like, come on. That's not enough for a video.
Wow.
I'm thinking about me.
And it's not just only like anime characters. Like, you could do anything from your childhood. You could dress up as a Disney princess, and they make money off those.
You look
too.
Like a Disney princess.
Like, why? Yeah, Disney princesses.
Hold on. Why like would Princess Leia be dressing up as like a childhood character and doing porn?
Dude.
That sounds disturbing to me.
It does.
That sounds disturbing as
fuck.
That's
the world.
Yeah. I didn't even know this existed. And right now, it's like a...
There's actually a term for it. It's called Rule 34. The Rule 34 of the internet is where if it exists, there's porn of it.
I need to start locking people up, dude. Because that sounds weird, dude.
Like,
I'm not even joking.
Probably one of the most... one of the biggest Disney... princesses to get Rule 34 is Elsa.
Frozen?
Yes.
Because she's Latin?
No, because... No, she's Swedish.
What?
Yeah.
Elsa's Swedish?
Yeah, she's
Latin. Is that Sarah?
Yeah. I am 90% sure Elsa's
Dude,
Swedish.
That's insane.
She's Ice Witch.
What?
She's based off Ice Witch. And that's Swedish.
Based off a light switch?
Folklore.
Speaking of Swedish, I saw Amon Amarth yesterday. It was awesome.
See who?
Amon Amarth.
Amon Amarth, yep. Some Viking warlord shit.
Mm-hmm.
Good show. If you guys haven't seen him, go see him.
Oh.
If you like metal.
I've listened to
him. If you don't like metal.
She's Norwegian.
Norwegian?
See, she's
even better. She's more Viking than... That's crazy.
That's Nordic. It's a Nordic tale.
She's not Sarah.
No, that's in her realm.
She's not Sarah.
That's in that realm.
Yeah, but she's not Sarah, though. Go ahead.
Okay. But, yeah. Ariel, Jasmine, all of them.
I've never... That thought, what you put together, or what you're saying, that thought...
Have you watched...
Never crossed my mind.
Have you watched 2.5 Ben?
No, I never watched the series.
All right, forget. I'm going to talk to him right now.
I'm sorry. I've never seen it. Well, so 2.5 Men is a series. Is that one of your favorite series?
Yeah, it could be that.
Yeah, that is probably, that is actually probably like
that. That's one of my favorite.
Yeah.
I got some good ones.
I think Seinfeld.
Seinfeld?
Is definitely that one.
Seinfeld, 2.5 Men.
Okay. You
here we go again, guys. With one of the ones I hate, you can ask one of my best friends.
Happy days.
I will be honest. I was also on that Seinfeld hate train until I binge watched it, and I have realized it is genius and way ahead of its time.
Yes.
I mean, maybe I need to give it another shot, but
you'll think like, wow, like people have done this a million times, but. You have to also realize they were the first ones to do it.
Yeah.
Oh. They like a lot of those tropes that you see in sitcoms happened because they put it in there. Like they put it on the map.
And you also wonder, how did they get away with it?
Yeah.
Some of them are like,
yeah,
really?
Some
on
of
TV?
Them are. Yeah.
Yeah. Some of them. Soup Nazi. Maybe,
like
maybe being that I'm older now, I should give it another shot.
Yeah, like
because I'm willing to do it, kind of expand my mind,
yeah,
but
like
from 10 years old to the now, I've never watched Seinfeld. I was like, dude, it's terrible.
The
It can't be that bad because it's been on forever.
Yeah, the jacking off episode. What? It is. What? It legitimately won so many awards because it is funny.
They made a bet.
Yeah. On who could go the longest without.
And Elaine even jumped in. Yeah. So Elaine was part of it.
Like, it wasn't just guys, it was also women.
So they came in there, I'm done. So Kramer comes in and goes, I'm done. I'm not doing it anymore. And they're like, stop it. So then I'll bet you. So him and then George, you'll last like a day or whatever.
Yeah.
And then, so then they all did it. They all jumped in. And then Elaine goes, I want on this. They're like, no, they can't work. And then so Kramer goes, you got to give us odds.
Wow.
Like 1,000 or something, something stupid. And then so they all did it. And then there was a girl across the street from George that used to do aerobics or whatever. I'm not from Jerry and the window. So Kramer's looking in the window. He's, I'll be back.
Wow. He says, I lost.
He puts the money on the table.
He just walks out.
And then George, I forgot what happened, but George did it. He comes back. And that's Elaine and Jerry. Elaine's in at her in her class, her workout class.
Like, are you the master of your own domain?
Yeah, the master. And so that John Kennedy Jr.
Yeah.
He comes and he's in the class, and then she was gonna get a ride with them or whatever with some damn. So that night, she has a dream about him. She comes in. Here you go. Wow. And then Jerry's all like, "Master of my domain," but he was with the girl. He was with the girl. So he was struggling. She was a virgin.
Oh,
so he was trying.
No, I think George won.
Huh?
I think George won.
No, Jerry won. Because remember, Jerry lost the virgin, and he lost everything. He won but he lost the virgin.
But I think I actually think George beat Elaine.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
That's wild. I didn't even know they had an episode like that. You get away with that on TV.
There's a lot of them. There's a lot of episodes like that.
And that episode is hilarious.
The soup Nazi, dude.
The soup Nazi is also.
He called the soup Nazi. Okay? That's just it. He was called the soup Nazi.
And that was also one of the episodes that like won a bunch of awards. But I think the other
Kind of comedy is it? It's supposed to be like, it's not slapstick, right? It's like,
it's
a show about a show.
They legitimately defined what a sitcom is.
It's a show about a show, nothing.
Right. Oh, okay.
It's a show about nothing.
Yeah.
How do you have a show about nothing? Nothing. What'd you do today?
Nothing.
That's a show. So you're gonna sit there and watch somebody do a show about, what about when you go eat?
It's a show.
They had hookers. There was another one, hookers.
What the fuck?
Dude,
the best episode is the Hamptons episode. Oh, that's my favorite episode for sure. I feel like that. That's also one of
before Jordan keeps going.
Mm-hmm.
Spoiler alert.
No. I'm not going to spoil anything on that one. But I would say that episode is like one of the. One of the shows I was talking about that is like a peak a TV show episode where you could have context or without context, and it is still probably one of the funniest things you've ever seen.
But you got to look at it. You can't go the first episode, that's stupid. You got, seriously, like he did. He was like almost going to go, and he started watching them.
Mm-hmm.
Then he's like, and then it like, oh.
Yeah. Okay. Because so I will.
You have to go as a continuation type thing.
Look at it. You have to look at it. You can't like look at the first one, look at the stupid.
Because I would also say the first season is not as good as the rest. I would say it's really funny, season 3 through 5.
Mm-hmm.
Like, absolutely hilarious. And then, it falls off a little bit, it goes up, and then it falls off.
Okay.
The one where Jerry Kramer does the chicken? The Rogers chicken? Rogers chicken?
Yeah.
That one's pretty funny. The one about he has a hot tub in his bedroom, in his living room, in an apartment.
Oh, that one's funny.
A hot tub in his apartment.
Yeah.
On the
everyone kept going to his room.
Yeah. Oh, then he had a smoking room. Room. Yeah. Everybody came to smoke in his room. Yeah. Yeah. Kramer's pretty funny.
Yeah, but there's like.
Newman. Yeah. Newman.
Yeah, but I would say Seinfeld is probably one of it is peak TV if you really look at it.
That's funny.
Do you know what's even funnier? This one I will spoil. There's like one scene where Kramer is with George and they're playing I think it was like Risk.
Oh no, that's Newman. Him and Newman.
Oh, him and Newman were playing Risk, and he's like talking about how he's going to.
Well, they have the game. First, they have the game. They're playing the game.
And on the subway.
So they're playing it first at the house.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then they put it at Jerry's house. Jerry, watch it, because otherwise Newman's going to cheat if they leave it at Newman's house. So they take it to Jerry's house and put it on top of his table. Watch this. So then Newman tried to sneak in Jerry's house to change the game, to mess with it. So all this is going on.
This is Jerry's sponsor.
Huh?
That's kind of funny.
Jerry's the main character.
Jerry's the main character. Okay. So then whatever, they start doing it. So Jerry finally gets done. Get out. Get the game out. So they take the game out, and they're walking with the game. They're on the subway playing the game. Yes. Yeah. that bad. So they're on the subway playing the game. And then Kramer starts talking about, what you going to do now?
I have the Ukraine surrounded.
Yeah. Yeah.
The Ukraine is weak. And then there's a Ukrainian guy on the train. Like, yeah. Ukraine not weak. Ukraine will smash. And he hits the board and ruins the game.
Yeah.
But it
they're talking about the war, risk game. Risk game. War.
Yeah. Oh, dude, Risk? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so the game, it's a war.
Yeah.
Game of, like...
Yeah, I understand.
So they're playing the game. There's a war right now in Ukraine on when they're saying, but, like, they were playing, talking about, but then the Ukraine guy on the...
Yeah, like, ruined the whole
Ukraine
not weak?
Yeah.
Ukraine will smash!
Yeah, because Kramer's going, they're weak. What are you going to do? You can't get this. And he's like, and he gets mad that the game's over now. So he just smashes it and ruined their game. So nobody won.
But that alone is way ahead of its time.
Nah, that's pretty wild.
They're real and they're spectacular. I want to tell you that one too, but that one's funny. But anyways, you gotta look at them. That one's good. What else, Jerk?
Oh, like TV shows that are really good? I honestly think Trailer Park Boys has one of those episodes where I would say that's peak TV.
And Trailer Park Boys is peak TV.
Like they are pretty stupid, but like that one, the one episode where they are like they're stealing gas and like reselling, like they open up their bootleg gas station.
This is highly illegal, Corey. It Trevor.
Absolutely hilarious, with or without context.
Yes,
I
can't watch that one. I can't watch. I'm Trailer Park Boys, dude. I'm sorry. Yeah.
Really?
Nope.
See, there's your no.
Yeah, like, but
why not? What's your?
If you watch that episode, I feel like you would. I pretty sure.
I think I seen that one. I think it's
so stupid, but it's hilarious.
I think it's that's where it's at. It's like that's too stupid. It went there.
Yeah,
I don't know. Somebody tried to make a hash driveway.
Yeah.
And the shit hawks are coming. The there's a shit storm brewing.
But like. There's gotta be. I can't think of many other TV shows where like you could watch it without context and be like, "This is such a good episode." Actually,
Married with Children.
A lot of Breaking Bad can do that, and a lot of Malcolm in the Middle could do that too.
Oh, dude, that's
Married with Children. That was fun. That was good.
I like Married with Children a lot. the things he would say and do. It's funny.
I can't think of a Friends episode where I would be like that. That's a hilarious.
Friends drives me crazy.
I tried watching Friends. I can't watch it.
My wife likes Friends. It drives me fucking.
It's hard. I watch. I can watch it.
Mm.
But it's just a little. Maybe it's a little too much New York-y.
Mm. Oh, actually, How I Met Your Mother.
Oh, that one's good. I like
it. Definitely has episodes where you could go like, "This is peak comedy." I think the
slap fight.
Huh?
The slap fight.
The slap fight.
That's great.
I've never seen How I Met Your Mother.
I also like.
No, I watched like a little bit of Always Sunny in Philadelphia. I always figured they're kind of similar.
Sunny in Philadelphia also has an episode that's like that too. But the How I Met Your Mother one, I think the peak like comedy for that one is probably
For You.
Oh, the Not a Father. I think Not a Father's Day is one of them. Mm. And the Crazy Hot and Hotness. Scale.
I gotta look at that one. Oh yeah, on a scale.
Yeah, in order for me to tolerate how crazy she is, she has to be at least this hot. So it's a little graph.
Is it like the guy who recently made the fuck around to find out scale?
Yeah.
Or the hot and crazy scale that the guy did before that one.
Okay, what's your TV shows?
Or TV shows? My number one TV show is Breaking Bad. It's not even close. It's like up here. And then
sitcom.
Sitcom?
Yeah.
Martin.
Martin?
Yeah, seasons 1 through 3. After 4 and 5 or that. But,
Martin. Martin was good.
Martin is good.
Like, it's, I guess you say it's more ethnic TV, as people like to say, you know, but Martin makes me laugh.
Martin was good back then. I tried looking at it again, watching it again. It's not the same.
No, it's not. I remember watching it with my auntie when I was young, and I found it super funny.
Yeah, it's fun. Wayne's brothers were fun back then, but then.
But you also have to, like, taken account, how well does that TV show age?
It aged pretty good, because, I mean, some of the stuff we talked about is still current.
Yeah, like, that's why I said, like, I think Seinfeld is there, because some of the stuff is still pretty relevant.
I mean, I know a lot of stuff from Martin. Damn, Gina. You know, there's things. Romy Rome in the house. Jerome's in the house. Jerome. That's Mark. He's Jerome. Jerome in the house.
Bro man.
Bro man was sick. He was the one. Bro man, okay. What you doing in here? Make some neat.
Now, this is gonna. Do you think Martin's character he had was it Jerome? It's not Jerome, but didn't it remind you of Jerome in the Zone?
James who?
Stewart.
Of course, that's what he did.
Okay, I just want to say because I was like that'd be from Martin. Like I just remember that.
It was so. That he was trying to do that. He did Prince. He did.
Yeah. But that's a whole
other
thing. But
yes.
Still, it's funny.
Mm. Yeah, that's what he did. What other one?
Staying in the comedy area or
just sitcom?
Yeah, if it's just sitcoms, then
you know what I liked a lot when I was younger. Even now, it's still good.
Barney.
Home Improvement.
Yeah, it was. There was some.
Mainly because he was in the garage and he's only had like the Power Drill 5000. That'd be like something just done so to such a high level that, and then the neighbor Wilson on the gate. Like I found it funny.
I also like South Park.
Oh, that's a whole other ball game. Yeah,
South Park is so.
They have so much that I've fallen off the wagon like a long time ago with South Park, dude. Like like bigger, longer uncut, and I'm kind of like. I've watched some of the new stuff too. It's fucking hilarious, but there's so much content that I'm like, I don't know how you guys are going this long.
Like, but it's still they're predicting funny.
The future.
Yes,
because they're predicting accurate. The future.
Yeah,
that's why.
I just want to know when we find space cash as the world.
Yeah, like
Mexico, you built a water park. That episode takes you out every time.
Right. That, like, those episodes, you wonder how did they not get canceled?
Yes.
South Park. They're part of them. Those are them.
They're they.
They. Yes, that's they. That's they.
They have a musical.
Yes.
Based around Mormons.
Yes.
The Mormons doing their missions in Africa.
I know.
It's hilarious.
That's they are they.
They're they?
They're
and
they.
It is funny.
Yeah. And who else is... I feel like Rick and Morty also...
Rick and Morty's different. It's definitely part of the science.
I haven't watched it. I haven't watched Rick and Morty. Mm. And I see these t-shirts.
Mm-hmm. It's
What about Old School?
Old School?
Old School.
The
old
movie?
School. No, Old School sitcoms.
How Old School?
Old School.
Like, Sanford and Son?
Oh, that was good.
Yes.
Okay, Sanford and Son, I don't know how, and then All in the Family and the Jeffersons. How did those three? How did those three stay afloat?
I don't know. I like
And right now, everybody, right now, I'm just going to say deja vu.
Really? With
Jordan's face, when I just said this right now, I remember talking about this before, and I said the same exact thing I'm saying right now, but we're going to keep going, and the studio wasn't here. But anyways, go ahead.
Good Times. That's what JJ.
Yeah, Good Times wasn't as bad.
No.
It was there. It was there though. It was pretty.
I mean, there was some like I remember we went back and watched some of like
All in the Family.
Yeah, All in the Family.
Yeah, but Jeffersons were just as bad. Really? George is bad.
Yeah.
Dude, he used to call Tom Honky.
Yeah, straight up.
Honky. Cracker. Honky.
Yeah, he did do, he did go.
And there. I forgot what he called the French, the English guy. He called him names too. Like, he was straight, like, yeah. And then Archie was bad, dude. He called everybody names. And they were going to remake it. They remade him.
Really?
They did them. Yeah, they did a remake of him.
Have you guys ever watched Little House on the Prairie?
Okay. No.
Oh, I just asked
him. I couldn't do that. I couldn't do Little House.
That's one of my mom's shows, so that's how I know about it.
And John Boy?
Yeah.
John Boy?
Good night, John Boy. A good series, but...
Good night, John Boy.
They do some fucked up shit in that series, too.
Yeah. Little House on the Prairie, that's what the girl, and that was what, no, that was, Little House on the Prairie wasn't John Boy. That was actually a TV thing. That was like Dallas or whatever, Little House on the Prairie.
Oh. Now I also realized, like, man, with like other TV shows that I liked, like, and then I thought of Game of Thrones, and that one just broke my heart. I was so into Game of Thrones,
and then the last two seasons. I watched in the middle, like, Game of Thrones when, that Frozen dude came about. I don't even know their names, like,
the Ice King?
Yeah, the Ice King guy, and they, like, fell in the fucking ice, and I watched that, and then the new series came out, I watched, like, two episodes, and I kind of fell off the wagon.
House of Dragon? House of Dragon's pretty good.
Did your mom ever watch, like, Days of Our Lives, or One Life to Live?
Oh, yeah. All those, man. I know all those
things. Couldn't do anything in the daytime when they were watching it? You didn't get to see that. You were lucky.
No. Yeah. One of my acting teachers was on an episode of Days of Our Lives. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You took acting class?
Look at him. No, he's acting right now. He's acting right now. Acting a fool.
High school.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
Yeah, I was in theater.
We had One Life to Live. We had Days of Our Lives. As the World Turns.
Yeah. This dude's going daytime television hard.
Yes. Dude, they were, like, seriously, parents, like, my mom would watch novellas.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, dude.
That's a whole other category, yes. Man.
Just stuck on
where they just keep doing the cuts?
No, she would watch over and watch over, and they were so, like, into it.
Your mother's also really into court TV.
Yes. No, now she's a court TV person. Oh. And she could watch the same one three, four, seven times, dude. Seriously. She knows that. She knows what's going to happen. Still watching again. Still watching.
Dang.
Still watching, dude. Yes, that lady. She's special. My mom is special. For those of you who know her, yes. She's a great lady. Great lady, but...
Yeah. It's one of the second favorite.
Yeah. Jordan's the second favorite. Her second favorite grandson. You know the favorite listens.
The favorite listens?
Favorite watches it.
Favorite watches.
Jason, talk to Jordan.
Give me notes.
Because he said he made a comment on the other one.
Nice.
He said, from what I remember,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, Jordan's mom didn't like you that much. She's not watching. from what I remember, Jordan's mom's not watching. Stop, dude. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think she watched. Sponsor. There you go.
I'm covering it. You can't even see it.
Hey, everybody, like the shirts. like and subscribe. Come in. Go on to our website and buy a shirt.
Yep.
Help out, mm-hmm. please. 24 Slayton in the building. The building?
This is still a building.
Okay. The building.
Yeah. It's a nice building.
Okay. Go ahead.
Tall ceilings.
Yeah, they're about a good 6.5 feet. No, but you won't know that because you don't watch it. He's just trying to. There's another podcast that's pretty big, but it's in a sport that's about this big, and he tried to bring it up, but it's not going to help us any.
No,
because this isn't helping us. That's not helping us. So, that mention's not going to really do too much either. But we'll see what happens.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, no. Even Brian doesn't watch that. So
really,
no. Brian listens to that. I'm trying to get Brian on here, but he lives so far, dude.
Really?
Yeah. He lives in Paris.
Oh, that's true.
He lives in Paris. Mm. Maybe when we go to LACR on the way, or Glen Helen on the way back.
Yeah, it's on the way. We could get him, snag him. We're gonna do an LACR trip. It'll be like, Ryan, you're gonna leave your truck in my house or your house.
No, he gets drive here.
Yeah.
Do it and do it. And go. I think so.
And that way you can kidnap him for a bit.
Yeah, maybe we'll get Jordan on too. Oh, Jordan's on. Hey, Jordan. How you doing? You're thinking about football.
Huh?
You're thinking about football. How'd you do this week?
I haven't done fantasy. Jessica quit that job, so. So you're fantasy, fantasy don't matter.
You're not fantasy no more?
Wait.
This guy over here?
Mm-hmm.
Fantasy everything.
Yeah, I went fantasy, in.
Everything.
Hard.
So if you want to join a fantasy.
He's hard in the paint.
He's trying to ruin a lot of careers.
So if you want to join a fantasy league.
I single-handedly destroyed the NBA.
So if you want to. Because if you want to.
Mugs are going down.
Well, you pick Schroeder.
No, that's not Schroeder. Not just him.
Schroeder.
There's. This is a whole other podcast we need to do on. We should do a podcast on fantasy sports, dude.
I'm trying to get my brother here.
Oh, yeah.
Arlen. My brother Arlen. You've been watching. You said, I'm going to come down here and you're going to be on this side of the table. You can actually come on this side of the table.
Dang. Like, over there?
You come right here, dude.
The VIP seating?
Right here. You're right next to me. Well,
come on, Arlen, so we can talk sports. I want to talk sports.
Yeah. He wants to talk. This guy wants to talk sports. This guy.
Mm. You don't know much about him.
Charles Pastrana.
Dude, because... Uncle's knowledge on sports?
Sponsor. Sponsor. Okay, turns good.
Uncle's knowledge on sports is...
No, I'm not levels. I'm not trying to debate him or anything. I just want to discuss it.
No, Dad, discuss it with him.
No, he's...
I'm sorry. Jacob, I forgot your name. But Jacob, him and Jacob, their sports knowledge... I want to do a sports podcast with those two.
Because their knowledge?
They're like pros. They would be
they
like pros. They should be at Sports Center.
They know a lot.
See, that's cool.
Arlen knows facts from like high school guys.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a
coming
whole...
up. But then again, he's a high school coach. So, but that was even before he was
before he even was a high school coach.
That's pretty.
He even knows stats on Madden. Madden stats. Yeah, stop it. Yes. Game. Yes. He's ridiculous.
I think
since his son plays like 8U, he probably knows 8U kid stats.
Yeah.
Like all the way down.
Huh? I hope he calls you out about that.
How was that one? Yeah. How was that one? Come on, Arden. I got you. Sit across the table and then it will be real.
Oh,
Jordan, he's just trying to put it in.
Yeah, dude,
get him.
I'm trying to see it happen. I've been wondering when he's gonna stop being El Nino because he's been saying he's gonna hop on.
Yeah.
Kiki's been on.
Yes, Kiki's been on.
Kiki has been on. Kiki says she's gonna come back too.
Yeah, she's ready. Mm-hmm. She was actually threatening the other day.
Ooh, come back. Nice.
Hey, so what? Your fantasy football league just disappeared, or
well. It doesn't matter if I do it anymore, so I haven't.
Oh, okay.
Because she don't work there anymore. Now, because they were doing it for, like, prizes and stuff.
Oh, okay, yeah. That's cool.
So you can't get prizes anymore?
Nope.
Well, that's not good.
Yeah, so.
You get 10.
Oh, and then she also told me to not do it anymore, so.
I do a podcast. I do a fantasy.
I do the motocross one, man.
I do a fantasy podcast. I mean, fantasy. Motocross.
Yeah.
Yep.
Undefeated. Cheater. Undefeated, everybody.
Cheater.
Undefeated.
That's the only
cheater. Sport I really watch at. So I don't like, I mean, what do you guys think? Like, why are people fans of sports? What does it do? Why are you a fan of sports?
Why am I a fan of sports? Because I like seeing competition. Yeah. The greatest. Oh, the people who have been drafted through that are the best in their respective sports. I like seeing that. I'm a fan of the athleticism and the competition. With that said, there's still sports I don't follow.
So does that being a fan or just liking the sport?
I say that's liking the sport, but being a fan of it is...
Different
and getting more involved a little bit, slightly. No, meaning that you're following the team, you're actually watching and hoping that they win each time and learning more.
So you become a fan of that team.
Yeah, I'm a fan of that team within the sport.
So what if you like the sport?
See, that's
the whole thing. Everybody involved, the whole thing. What is that?
then you're a fan of the sport.
Or I just like the sport.
Yeah, that's cool, yeah, too.
You could just like the sport, or you could just
And that's actually kind of a little bit more organic, too, to just like the sport. Because, and what I mean by that is, if you like it, it means you either tried it or played it, or you just like watching it. Something you like about it.
Oh, I am a fan of something else. Not a fan, I like something else.
What?
I like UFC.
Oh,
and
you
boxing.
Do.
That's
and
true.
Boxing.
That
and
is
boxing.
True.
And yeah. boxing. But I kind of know both of them, so that mm-hmm. too.
Yeah.
Not to a David, Fat David.
Oh. Or
not to a Fat David level, but.
Or like.
I know it.
Or like Pop's level?
No. Well, no, I. Yeah, not that level either. Maybe like Chip. Not like Chip either, but yeah, I know that. Mm-hmm. Not Chip, mine. Chip. The surgeon.
Oh.
The Muay Thai champ. Oh, you're not champion no more, Chip. Get it back. Go ahead. Does he watch? I hope so.
Yeah, so that's where I think it just changes, like, what being a fan is. I don't know. Some people just aren't the fan of the sports.
Some are just, like, obsessed.
No. I mean, some of them just
aren't. There are some people that are obsessed.
Yes, like, over the top.
Obsessed. Oh, yeah, true. And that's a whole other level that I don't know.
That's another one of your pet peeves.
What?
When you refer to a team as we.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's an actual overall pet peeve for you?
Yes.
Okay, all right. I can already tell. I'm not even going to go down
no,
that
No, no. Like, it's...
If you say we...
Like, you're not doing anything. You're not even helping
you're
us.
You're emotionally invested. That's why people say we.
But...
And, like, what are you...
You're emotionally there.
Hey, but when...
You're living and dying with it, you know? Like, every owl, whatever.
You do have those moments where you are... When you are we.
Yes, with Malcolm.
With Malcolm.
But I put the jersey on, we ride.
He puts the jersey on and he's riding with Malcolm. When Malcolm goes on the jumps, he...
But the whole thing is, like, pulley too. Pulley. I do both, because, I mean, Malcolm, I call him. I'll text him. Dude, Malcolm, this and this. I he might not even read it. But it's we now, because I'm seeing something here. I'm seeing something here. Okay, We're a coach.
Yeah.
Or not that I'm not my coach, and we boys, but you know, hopefully he like goes, oh yeah, I didn't see that. You
the know? Other time we is acceptable is when I'm a Kings fan, because I had the Kobe beard.
Yeah, but you're not playing.
Yeah. That doesn't count. You have the beard to play on the beard.
Mark says he looks like Kopitar.
Yeah.
A little bit.
Okay.
Vaguely.
I also looked like Bieber. Yeah. I looked like a lot of people.
He was Bieber for a long time. When he was younger, when he was dumb shows, he was Bieber.
Yeah.
Everybody thought it was Bieber. Like,
yeah, they legit thought I was Bieber.
You should have took pictures of people and like...
He did.
I did.
they probably took him like, same Bieber. This ain't Justin.
I saw the dude who was playing as Michael Jordan, 23. It was on Instagram. And he's taking photos. It's kind of the same thing. Oh, fake guy. That's what I'm getting at.
Nice.
That's all.
You should take pictures. You look just like Anthony Wyckoff.
Exactly. World renowned. Famous.
Give us some shout outs. Let's get up there. Give us another 100. Give us 1,000.
Give us 1,000 people. Huh?
Yeah. Yeah. Come on. Help us out. Sponsor.
Can't. Unfortunately.
No, it's not going to work?
No. Okay.
All right. So, your favorite football team?
Favorite football team?
Yes. Oh yeah, you're the
Chargers, baby.
He just started out. Brand new. He's brand new.
He's been a Chargers fan for 1 year.
Yeah, but he started watching. He just kind of started watching.
I just started watching football though, so that's my
basketball.
Lakers.
LeBron James. Ew. Okay, Jordan.
Well, don't disrespect the GOAT.
Stop it. Stop it. They get rid of him, they win a championship.
I don't have a favorite basketball or football team.
Okay.
But I do like watching it.
On baseball.
Atlanta Braves.
It'd be Yankees. But that's because, okay.
Yankees?
One of the other things I was going to talk about.
It's a family thing.
On why people are fans.
Because of family.
It's because of family.
Yeah.
Oh.
Like you get indoctrinated by your family, so it's kind of like a cult.
Yeah. You might want to cut them out of your fandom.
It's all
right.
I like Lakers. I like Lakers. They're LA team. Uh-huh. I like Dodgers. LA team. I like the Kings, since purple and gold. LA team.
Yeah.
I like Barry Sanders. He retired. Football's done.
You and the one athlete retired.
That's it. No, you retired. Once Barry Sanders retired.
Yes, I like Barry Sanders. I like Barry Sanders.
I like the player, and that's it.
That's it. I like Barry Sanders. It was cool. Everything. I was Barry Sanders. And there were the good players, teams. I did not like the Lions because they were horrible. Actually, Jason's team is the Lions.
Jason's team's the Lions?
Jason, your team's the Lions. Favorite. Grandma's favorite.
Yeah.
So he liked the Lions. He likes them now. That's his team.
With Jared Goff?
Granny's team is the Steelers.
Oh, yeah. She's a hardcore Steeler fan.
Anthony is Raiders.
Yeah. Makes
Raiders. Yeah. Makes sense. Yeah. Jason is Detroit. He's been Detroit.
Huh. And you're Barry Sanders.
I was Barry Sanders. That's it. And then Arlen is Rams.
He's Rams. Yeah.
I think he's Rams, right?
Yeah, Uncle's Rams.
Okay.
Yeah, he's always been Rams. Mm-hmm. He was saying Rams back in 97 at the Coliseum.
So is Mark. So is Mark.
Mark's the Rams?
Mark's, he has a Rams jacket, dude. Letterman's jacket.
Oh, shit.
With 22 on it.
Oh.
Yes, Mark. Mm-hmm. Mark and Jacob, I think. Yeah, Jacob has season tickets. Yeah, they're hardcore.
Yes. Okay, so at the season ticket mark, does that mean you've gone from fan to obsession?
Could.
No, like, I think that's super fan.
Yeah, super fan.
Okay.
Yeah, because like you could be a super fan, but not like be a, like just constantly only talk about them.
I don't think he has a whole room. Like when you have the whole room, the shrine.
Oh, dude. Yeah. Same,
like yours?
What's playing? I see it.
You've seen it?
Yeah, I've seen a Boston Red Sox room of baseball shit. I was like, whoa, where'd you get all of
this? Wait a minute, hold on. I know somebody like that. And he's probably watching the podcast right now. Not right now, but he watches it.
Who?
Mark. Mark. Bronco Mark. That's his.
Bronco Mark,
yes.
I have no idea.
My best friend from a long time ago. He's still my friend. I seen him like the other day. Bronco Mark is Broncos.
Broncos.
How do you feel about that contract?
Yeah, dude. Russell.
Dude, he's a Broncos fan from way back.
Oh, okay.
Cooking with Russ.
So way back. Terrell Davis?
Way back. He's
fan. John Elway?
And he had Manning.
Or fast
way back. Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's from the jump.
But he's got Russell now. You cooking with Russ.
Okay, dude. He's a Bronco fan. I was a Barry Sanders fan. So he had a horrible team.
It would be like it's on the level of you liking the Lakers with Russell Westbrook.
If Russell's fine.
Yeah, Russell's cool.
Russell's fine.
Westbrook is cool.
LeBron James. LeBron James is the problem. That's the problem.
Okay.
And the other guy who's fragile.
Anthony Davis?
Yes. He's out again for, a month?
Yeah.
Another month, dude.
I told my buddy when he drafted, I was like, dude, you should not have drafted Davis. And he was like, well, he's going to be good. Wait, and he went off. No, I didn't.
You said you shouldn't have drafted?
I told him because I had him before.
Yeah, like he's like, on your power.
On your fantasy.
Fantasy, yeah. So he got him. Once again, he did good. He did really good for him in the beginning. First 2 months, down. That was down. Like, I told him, bro.
Sponsorship.
I told him so.
It's also like picking, what's his name? Derrick Rose.
Yeah. That's a big danger zone, unfortunately.
Why?
Always.
D-Rose, dude.
D-Rose is sick. But the thing is, D-Rose keeps getting hurt.
Same thing with Blake Griffin.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. See?
It's kind of crazy how injuries really can match you up like that. Like, so.
Well, if you can't play, you can't get paid.
No.
You know what's funny though? Hockey players get hurt.
Play through that shit.
They keep playing.
I don't.
But they don't get paid that much.
Nope.
Mm-hmm.
Well, they get paid, but they don't get paid that money.
Fucking massive injuries.
I was watching the one about the DeMayer or something like that. High stick. He got hit.
And boom. The teeth?
And he broke his teeth. Broke his tooth. He goes, I broke all my surgery dental work. I broke. Done. Mm-hmm. And he goes, just one of them's loose. He goes, you want to pull it out so you don't swallow it? He went. And then handed it to the trainer. Put his mouthpiece back in.
Walked back in.
Yes, ready to go. Ready to go.
Now,
well, I mean, it's probably different because if he had dental work, because he's probably broken before, they're probably like, there's no nerves. So you can.
Yeah.
But still.
It's still gnarly because for the NBA player, he's out for 3 months.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm saying.
Football player, sprains a wrist, sprains an ankle, sprains a finger.
Mm-hmm. Still playing.
No, football players don't.
I don't know, man. They've been playing through some massive injuries.
No, like, his guy.
Yeah, Justin Herbert. With the
Justin Herbert has been playing through a lot of injuries.
Surprisingly, but NBA, dude, this year is bad. Like, the sprains and all their injuries. Like, I had Tyler Hero out for...
They get paid too much money.
14 games over a sprained ankle. Not even a grade 3 sprained ankle. Like, they said it was, like, grade 1.
And we can't really... Basketball, he can't jump. He can't...
Yeah.
Same thing with baseball. If they hurt something, they can't do anything.
Dude, last year I had Mitch Haniger, and he did not play for, like, there's 120 game season, I believe. 100, like, at least 100 games he did not play for me. I was expecting big things when he came back.
But that's why I like motocross.
But then
they come back.
But then there were times that they did play him, and then they got yelled at for playing him. Like, Tua. Okay.
Well, that's what
happened. Yeah, the Tua Tagliova.
That was bad, though.
Yeah, the concussion?
Yeah, I should have played.
Yeah. Huh?
Well, there's things that you shouldn't play through, but,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that concussion was bad. The first concussion was bad. The second concussion was really bad.
Yeah. Well, that's...
And that was back-to-back games.
Yeah, I seen that one. Yeah. I actually seen that.
Mm-hmm.
Sports Center.
Yeah.
And Sports Center replayed his
hands
throwing up gang signs quite a bit.
I like it. Gang signs.
That was messed up, dude. So that was a meme I saw.
So what do you think? What were we talking about? Sports?
Super fans. Or fans. Super. What makes a fan of a sport?
I think I'm a super fan of motocross. Or supercross. Or both.
We're both super fans of motocross. I think you're more so than me because you know more...
You know them.
Details.
But see, that's the thing. I mean, are you a super fan if you know a lot of them?
Yeah. You're involved.
But I'm not a super fan. I know them. Like, I don't...
Like, personally
geek out.
Know.
Yeah, I don't geek out.
You don't have to geek out with them.
That's
the cool thing about supercars. You don't have to geek out, like...
Well, that's what I mean. Superfans kind of like, oh, my God.
Like idolizing a player? That's
different.
Yeah. That was me. Barry Sanders.
Yeah.
Maybe that's... I didn't idolize him, but it was that was my dude.
Yeah. That's your boy. It's my dude. But, like, a lot of people... That's, like... I feel like that's your line. But also,
it depends on the person and your personality, because some people can't, like, they get starstruck when they meet somebody famous.
Yeah, but...
And that they really, really like. Like, well, at Glen Helen, when we met Chad, when he was all, like, in disguise, because he wasn't racing. I didn't feel starstruck when I met him, and we were all standing in the circle, but I really liked the way road race. I liked Chad at the time, and I was like, dude, that's cool. And I wasn't going to blow his cover. Like, oh, my God, you're Chad Reed. Can I get your autograph? Can I get a picture? And it wasn't good.
But another thing is we're not like that because we've met them. Like, I feel like I was like that as a kid. But then when I was at Dub.
You were a big Jeremy fan, but you weren't really, you didn't really. At
least... Dude, he told Jeremy he was going to beat him.
That's what I'm saying.
I did?
He was going to race this. When he was going to do that stupid supercross thing, he said, watch, Jeremy, I'm going to beat him. That's and I'm gonna dance like Bubba.
I did say that?
Yes, this guy. So he called out the GOAT, dude.
Supercross. I like it.
I have some confidence then.
Yeah.
But still, like, I think it's more so how you're raised if you get starstruck around.
Yeah, but like.
I mean, he was around them since he was 2 years old, 3 years old. So, I mean.
Wasn't that like, oh my God.
But like, even the rappers and stuff, too.
Yeah, well, like, you were still around them since you were like 3.
That's true.
You were in the scene. You were dancing on stage when you were 3 years or 4 years old.
Yeah.
No, wait a minute. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, two, 7 years old.
Just for some people. They're humans just like us. So
yeah.
It's like,
are they?
Yes. Except for the alien
they're
ones
not aliens.
About.
They're not human like me.
Except for the alien ones you talked about.
He's met a lot of them.
Yeah. That's a whole other thing. You should do a podcast on that.
On what? Aliens?
No.
Let's do it.
Personalities you've met. Without naming names, like just how they are.
You name names.
No, without names.
You
name
names.
Without. That's without another one. That's another Seinfeld. She named names.
But yeah, just how people are and dealing with them.
Jordan doesn't like dealing with people.
Oh,
Jordan, I don't think Jordan can ever work retail.
I can't.
Jordan couldn't work retail because we worked a Dub show and Jordan was working the free t-shirt line. And Dick. This guy couldn't do it. He was.
It was just some people. Yes.
Entitled. Some people, dude. Entitled.
They are entitled. And well,
if you have a wristband.
Were you dropping the U people when you're out there then?
Yes. Yes, U people. Dude. Sponsor. Go ahead, sponsor. We're looking for one. Looking for one. There you go. Oh, sponsor. Jose, hook us up. Sponsor. Thank you.
So what happened?
I sent you my information. I sent you information, Jose. I sent you the information. Maybe I'll reach out again. But go ahead. We're looking better. I mean, they'll look good right here. Right here.
Ooh.
Right here. I look good. Sponsor.
Yeah, but we had...
Go ahead. Go ahead. Or I'll put one right there and then one here. So, So when we go like this, there'll be one right there. And then we go like that. There'll be one right here.
So,
Polly, help me out. Sponsor. We need sponsors.
So,
let me pull some of yours. A couple. Like, maybe three. Go ahead.
Those are cool.
So, what?
Polly, me and Polly work together. I've been, like, his contracts, we've been talking about him. And I help him out with his contract. We're good. Just because you went to Paul and watched them race. You know, whatever.
Watch them race.
Watch him ride. Look at me. I'm going to take a picture. Look at the whoops. They're all beat up.
Hey, dude, those seem rough.
Yeah.
He hit them pretty good, though.
Okay, hold on. Yep. Stamped it. Dollar. Polly makes A1.
Why are you putting on blast?
Night show.
Why are you putting on blast?
No, we'll just go.
Get in, yes. We're going to do the dollar. We're going to do the dollar.
No, I got a dollar. He makes it in.
I don't want to bet. Why I got to bet against him? I got two.
Because I called out first. I called it first.
Then I have to bet against him. That's messed up.
And then you'll get next week. I'll go back to back.
All right. Okay. We got to do that, but I still want you in.
Of course. A1.
Yeah.
You're going to be there. We'll be there.
Yeah, we'll be there. Turn on Slayton podcast crew will be there.
Yes. We might even do a podcast of David Pulley at the races.
Ooh.
Yes.
Nice.
In the Knothole Club.
He's going to be racing. He ain't got time to be up at Knothole Club. Making my dollar. Okay?
All right.
Okay.
Oh,
everybody out here, watch Supercross. It's fun. It's my favorite sport.
Yep. Best sport in the world.
I ride motocross, but I like Supercross. If I was like 30 years younger, I'd ride Supercross. 35 years younger.
Somewhere in there.
I'm 30 years younger than you.
40 years younger, I'd do it. Shit, I go ride Supercross tomorrow. I'd roll the shit out. I'd double the hell out of that track. I'd double the hell out of that Supercross track. You guys.
Rah.
My bike don't sound like that. Anyways, my bike's much deeper. So, where are we at again?
Don't start doing the bike sounds. Just don't do it.
Yeah, don't.
So,
where are we going? Yeah, don't. I don't want to get on that level because... Annoying, but anyways.
I want to go there right now.
No,
but...
don't. Do not go there. Okay, right. I will cut your mic somehow. I can cut it.
That's fine.
I'll cut all the mics.
Podcast over.
Yes, we will cut it right there. Cut, and then I'll edit it out.
All right, George. So you're at the t-shirt line working retail. You can't work retail.
Oh no, he can't. We're a dub show, Dallas mm-hmm. show. When I work for dub, and I brought. I said, so what are you doing next weekend? Oh, nothing. So let's go to Dallas. Okay. So when he goes to Dallas, we need to help set up. So John brings him in so he gets help set up, and then he works the show. So as he's working the show, he puts him in the t-shirt line, the free t-shirt line. Mm-hmm. So if you have you buy a pass, which has a free t-shirt, and then you get front access to the autograph lines. And then there's a little VIP area in the front where you can stand there and watch the concert for closer.
Okay.
So they were coming and they were there. And they're all in line to get free t-shirts. And I'm like...
But here's the issue. One of the issues is that they label it VIP pass.
What is a VIP pass?
Mm-hmm.
It's a VIP pass.
Yeah.
But it's VIP for the front of the line, mm-hmm. VIP for the front of the autograph sessions, mm-hmm. and it's just a free t-shirt.
Mm-hmm.
So, but they
but.
Now you go and you have to get in line. Mm-hmm. They would want to get in line first of all mm-hmm. to get a free t-shirt. So there's a line, long line.
Yeah, I know how long those lines.
Okay, so they're in the line to get a free t-shirt. Some people are going to buy shirts mm-hmm. or hats, or lanyards or whatever they're going to buy.
Yeah, basically merch table.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. So they're there, and then people are, there's a free shirt right there. So they come up and ask, hey, can I get a free shirt? Here's my thing. So the people that are in line are buying. Oh, I got a free shirt. Okay. So we make another line for the free t-shirt line because there's so many people. Mm-hmm. That line is just ridiculous.
No, it is.
But now nobody wants to wait in that line because you want to lose sales to give out free t-shirts. So you make a pay line, free t-shirt line. Well, the free t-shirt line people are in line. They don't want to wait. So they kind of come around and whatever. And I'm trying to help the money line. Okay. As the money line's going, people come, I have a shirt. Get in line. I don't want to wait in line. I got a VIP. So do they. Okay, so
that's what we say.
So everybody wants to get in line. Nobody wants to get in line. So, you know, every once in a while we get somebody to come and help us to give out free t-shirts. Well, it doesn't say size. It's a shirt. We have boxes.
Yeah.
And 500-700 people.
Or so more.
So it's like, here's a shirt. Here's a shirt. Here's... Oh, my God, dude. Yeah, it's all these people doing it.
Wait, what happened? Right,
nothing. It's all these people doing it. And then we're like, dude, what the hell? Like, why so many people?
Yeah.
And they're just coming in from the side, from the side, from the side. And Jordan's like just... Jordan's here. Jordan's here. And he's like just trying to do it. And okay, we're in Dallas.
Yeah.
Bad. People don't.
Yeah,
no sense. Oh, yeah. I'm not saying that people in Dallas don't have sense, but these people had no sense. And they wanted some stuff done. And I don't know if you're going to watch the podcast, but if you did and you didn't have the sense, comment on the bottom. Yeah. Just call him on. Go ahead. Whatever. So we're good. But yeah, it was bad, dude. Jordan was just freaking out. He was like just trying to do it and trying to get through it. And he's like, I hate this place. Sponsor. I hate this place. He's like, I hate this place. He did not want to come back.
I've done some shows. I've done other shows. I've gone to Sturgis.
Mm-hmm.
I've gone to like Miami.
Yeah.
I've gone to a lot of places.
New Jersey. He did New Jersey, Miami, Dallas, Houston.
Vegas.
Houston, Vegas.
And Dallas, LA.
No, you never done Vegas. You never done Vegas.
I did LA with you guys.
Yeah. Oh, we did another cool place.
LA?
Yeah.
Cool place?
Like the northern places.
I don't know where else you did. Did you do Chicago or Detroit?
Yeah, I did Chicago.
Chicago? Yeah, that was cool.
But Dallas?
He was done. Atlanta's not much better either. But
I would bet.
You Atlanteans. But,
I remember doing the LA show. My feet were smoked after that.
I walked a
lot of steps.
I do 15 miles inside a convention center. How is that possible? 15 miles.
You like were this. Gone. You were like, Dave, you're going to go. Dave, go over here and help put up this for Swift and then do this, and you were gone. Tim was gone. I'm like, shit, okay, and then go over to the next booth. I remember went over to the booth of the girls taking photos, and I was doing something over there that he asked me to do. I was like, all right. And Tim, gone. Yeah. It was like he would get me set up for a second, and then he'd circle back, gone. And it was just like, go over here. It was a good time, though. It was cool.
You got to see. Good thing you didn't say, hey, can you give me a job? Then I said, yeah, you want a job? Talk to Miles, then show up Monday, bring a bag. Then show up and you're gone for like a month, like 3-4 months, dude.
Yeah. I'm...
8 months. Mm-hmm. That's what happened to Nick, my friend Nick. Nick, I want to tell the story when you're here, but you know, since you're not here, you said you're coming. El Nino. Get me a job, get me a job. So I was like,
I think I'm still too young.
I was like, you don't want here, dude, you don't want a job. He was 18.
Oh, okay.
He said, I want a job. I said, you don't want to work here. He's like, I want to work. I said, all right. So I talked to him. They said, all right, tell him to come on, whatever. Bring his bag. So I told him, I think I told him Saturday. No, Sunday. I told him Sunday. Monday, be at the shop at Monday. Mm-hmm. Bring your bag. Pack your clothes. He goes, all right, how long am I going to be done? I said, you'll be gone for a while. So pack about, you know, 30 days, whatever. About 15 days worth of clothes. So he left, came back 6 months later. Gone. On the road. Nick grew up like
on the road this. Again.
Nick grew up like that, dude.
On the road again.
18, on the road, nonstop. Yeah. And he's seen the whole nation.
That's kind of gnarly. It's just like, hey, you got a job. Show Monday.
He wanted to work. I told him. But it was good. He liked it. It was a good experience.
At that time, I was only 16.
Two years later, I could have had you.
Yeah, but I don't even.
I think I left.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You did. But it was still cool, though.
You still know the guy who owns it. He could have got you hooked up.
True. Yeah.
He would have thrown you to the wolves.
I don't know what's worse, that or paving.
What did you do on paving? All you did on paving was like hold a sign and watch a dog, you and David. Dude, I forgot to tell David that story. I feel like calling him right now. Damn it. What? Okay, so listen to this one. Listen to this
one. No, you gotta wait for Jordan. David to be here.
No. David, you better text in or something. Just get on the bottom. Okay, so, dude, we're at a job. I have a job. It's a big HOA, and we're doing it. So we're doing the street, and I'm the supervisor or whatever. I think I'm supervisor, foreman, project manager. So I'm there watching, and I needed traffic control. Mm-hmm. I got Jordan, and I got David. Just hold the signs. Stop and slow. Which nobody listens to.
Wait, boxing, David?
Oh.
Yes. Okay. Which nobody looks at signs. They don't care. Yeah. You know. Stop and slow them.
They don't care.
Okay, so. So I'm driving by. I think I'm driving by in the water truck. Driving by in something. And I'm going up, and then Jordan's here, and then I'm going to the next one where David's at. And I'm inside the construction area going up, and then they're going. So there's this huge Rottweiler, dude. Huge Rottweiler. He was, dude, big guy. So he goes, and I like, David's like, oh shit, dog. I said, dude, he's cool. I go, puppy. Dude, dog starts barking at him. And Dave goes, dude, what the hell?
This is all on the radio.
Yeah.
The radio's on.
So I have the radio on, and I go, puppy. And you can hear it. The dog like goes like barking at Dave. He puts a sign up to stop. Dude, I'm dying. But again, puppy. And the dog's freaking out, dude. But he has a sign there. Tell him to stop.
Oh, dude, man.
David was hilarious. I would get David, but he's having too much fun right now.
Yeah,
he's kind of cooning it right now, I think. Oh, yeah. And it's money. Yeah, David, dude, it was. Yeah, if you were there,
that's pretty damn funny.
And Jordan's down on this side, like way on the bottom of the hill. David's on top, and he's like trying to. That was funny.
It sounds pretty funny, honestly.
And the dog just like was like mad at him. Yeah. I think the dog was mad because he had the stop sign. He didn't want to stop.
Don't tell me what to do.
You're not the boss of me.
You're not my dad.
Oh, shit, dude. So, that's pretty funny. Yeah, pretty funny story, dude.
But every time, like, dog would be barking and growling, like, puppy, and you could hear it on the radio.
It started barking louder.
Dude, Tim, stop. Dude, Tim, stop.
He got mad.
Yeah, he got mad. Dude, Tim, stop. Yeah.
I can see his face.
Really angry.
And Jordan's dying down there. Not even holding his top side up.
I would have been laughing hysterically too, man.
Yes.
That's pretty damn funny because
you know
I can picture David's face saying that.
You would have been laughing unless it was you.
Oh, yeah. I would have been would not have been cool. For me. For sure.
Tim, stop.
David's crying.
Yeah, dude.
David's crying. We got him. Oh, this is funny. Poor David. I forgot all about it. I had him right there. Dude. Right there. I could have had him.
You had the puppy story, dude.
Damn. And now every time I see a puppy?
Yeah.
Puppy.
Dude, next time I see him on the track, I'm bringing it up to him.
I'll tell him. I'll just say it. Next time we're at the track, and he's there, I'm like, puppy. And he'll be like, dude, he'll tell the whole story.
Definitely.
He'll tell the story because it's funny. Oh, you know what? Now Brian's probably going to tell him.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Fred's probably going to tell him. Mm-hmm. Fred, are you watching? You better be watching, Fred. We went all the way up there to see you.
That is true.
Yes.
But it was a fun ride with you.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, it was. Fast track.
Yep.
Very hard packed.
Yeah.
Very slippery. For him.
Wasn't slippery for me. For him. I tracked it for days.
You did?
Yeah, but the rear end.
How'd you fall?
Not knowing how to ride.
How'd you fall?
Going to the turn. Got a brake.
Slippery.
Oh, yeah. Front went up and over that little rut, but.
What happened? Slippery. For him.
Yeah. Another dude who looped out.
Dude, there's a jump. There's a jump where this guy looped out. But there's a jump. Like a tape finish line jump.
Yeah.
And Fred's all, dude, everybody goes to that jump. The only wrecks we see are right there. And like guys like break their femur and stuff. I'm like, don't jump it. He goes, try not to jump because nobody jumps it. I'm like, don't jump it. It's small.
It's very small.
Yeah. Short, it's small.
It is small.
But it's what it is. It's really slippery on the other side. Mm-hmm. And if you don't stop straight at an angle, it kind of washes. So it's a little different. And a lot of people use their back brakes there. Mm-hmm. So I jumped it and I kept jumping it with my front. I'm jumping it to prove a point.
They just like, don't call me a bitch.
He proved a point. I fell in that turn. I fell all stupid like, and then the dude looped out and elbowed himself.
This dude, like, I'm watching, I'm looking for whatever, and I see this guy go like, dude, he's like front wheel high, like way up there, jumping like David, like this.
I don't jump like that.
David.
Oh.
Fat David. So he's way up like this, way up there, dude. And I see him, he's gonna fall. I'm like, dude, like this is not gonna be good. He's like this. Mm-hmm. So he goes and he clips the end of it. Mm-hmm. And so it brings the front end down. Mm-hmm. Now the front end comes down, he's sliding out the back, wide open, whiskey. He's whiskey throttle. Whiskey throttle. So he goes down the hill, whiskey throttle on a wheel, Willie. Then at the bottom, it loops. He's lucky that it looped at the bottom because it's really muddy. Mm-hmm. And it was like thick mud. So he got into it like, it's a little bit softer. Otherwise, on the hard packed, oh, he would have been hurt. Hurting. So I turned real fast and I went up on top of the jump to stop people because I didn't know where he landed because I stopped looking. And then he had got up and crawled to the edge and jumped off the track. Mm-hmm. And then everybody was there. So I there's nobody coming. So I stopped the people and then I went and told him, I go, you good? Can you feel your legs? He goes, yeah, I go, it hurts. He goes, my ass. I'm like, nice. Did you get any mud in there? Mud in there? He's like, nah, I'm good. I'm like, all right. Here come the paramedics. And then he was cool. But he sat up and walked away.
Yeah. Nice.
He's probably sore.
Dude, he's hurting today.
He's sore right now. Yeah.
His ass impact is pretty hard. Like, it was like his, the speed that he got when he whiskeyed, it wasn't a slow whiskey like some guys, like where they roll it on and you can see it slow. It was like raw and fucking just slam his ass into the ground.
Chad, remember the one he did the Willy and Willy and you flipped over and you had ass was hurt for like 3 months, 4 months?
Yeah.
I think your ass still hurts, Chad. But it was like that.
Yeah, he's going
to
be
sorry hurt. To call you out, Chad. My bad.
That dude's ass is going to be hurt for a bit.
Yeah, he was in pain.
Speaking of
asses?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hi. Guess what I did yesterday?
Sat on your ass?
No.
Oh.
Went to a ballet.
Ballet, nice.
Yeah. Well, my cousin.
Which one?
Nutcracker.
Your friend's Nutcracker?
No.
Oh.
Jessica.
Okay. I said, which one? You said Nutcracker.
I thought you were asking which ballet.
Cousin. Which cousin? Because you have more than one, I think.
I've got.
Okay, there you go. See? More than one.
Got a lot.
Nutcracker. Did you wear your suit?
No.
Oh, you should have worn a Nutcracker suit to go see the Nutcracker. That would have been sweet.
That's second generation away. But, dude, one of the guys had the tightest pants.
Nice.
Like, you see everything. Like
Justin Barsha.
Wait a second.
Justin Barsha.
You said ass. You started talking about dude's ass. I don't know what dude's ass. I thought you were talking about, like, a BBL at the Nutcracker dance or something. Shit.
No. Oh. Like you're like there and you're like, what the hell is going on?
Tim's like, what the fuck?
This guy, dude.
You invited him.
This guy. I'm looking at his, like, what? Anyways, go ahead, George.
Yeah. And the tightest pants. I'm like, what the hell is going on?
And did you enjoy it?
Huh?
Wait, do you remember the picture? Remember the picture I sent you?
Yes.
I was standing in line. Mm-hmm. Dude, a long time ago. I'm standing in line. And, dude, I'm standing in line, and I'm like, this dude's pants were the tightest pants. And he had to be wearing Skims or whatever they're called, dude. Cause
wait, that was a dude?
Yes, that was a dude.
I have no idea.
I was like, what the? Are you freaking serious, dude? But, hey, but they're okay. But that, yeah, it was. They were so tight, dude. Like,
that's wild.
They weren't tight. They were tight from the top. Let me see. Hold on. They were top from here to here. They were tight the whole way, dude. Down.
This guy used to be Skinny Jean guy.
Oh, yeah, you're Skinny Jean guy.
No, I wasn't.
No?
Well, that's Skinny Jean guy.
You're Skinny Jean guy.
Yeah, you were definitely a Skinny Jean guy.
Yeah.
No. Because I listen to hardcore music, man. I was a Skinny Jean guy. A metalcore, rather.
I think you're a Skinny Jean
guy. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you were a Skinny Jean guy in high school.
Or maybe Steven.
I don't, maybe? I don't know. I don't remember.
I think you had Skinny Jean.
I think you're a Skinny Jean guy for a...
They might have been tight, but they're skinny.
Yeah.
Probably possibility. I don't know. Yes. Oh, when I was BMXing, yeah, I did have a pair then. That's right. So we're going back to... That is 05, 04. That's like, took a minute, but yeah.
You were in? That's what was in? Yeah. That's what was in? Nice. I like it.
Generally speaking.
Should bring them back. Mm-hmm. You know, if you rode the way you rode on Saturday and had skinny jeans on or skinny pants, it'd fit. It'd work. It would work.
That would look funny.
Because you had tuck butt.
Oh, tuck butt. It's so bad, man. I never had tuck butt before.
He had tuck.
100%.
He had tuck butt.
I had never had tuck butt before this weekend, and it was full effect. Tuck butting this weekend was so bad.
I watched him ride.
Yeah.
Like, I watched him ride. And then I'm looking at him like, what is he doing? He's standing straight up, tucked his butt. Yeah. Straight up. I'm like, who rides like this? And he was the one talking about, like, goon. Like, my goggles were a little bit, my strap was a little low on the handlebar. But I don't care. I'm fucking fast. Okay?
So, that was a different day.
So my strap is a little higher on my helmet, right? And it's not perfectly straight. I don't care. I'm not that kind of guy. I'm not, I'm a goon rider.
You're not a goon rider.
I'm one of the fastest, smoothest goon riders ever. Okay? This guy was tuck butted. Straight legs.
Yeah, it was so bad,
just
man.
Gooned out, dude. Gooned out.
Yes.
And he's trying to call me out on a strap.
It was bad. It was bad. Definitely went gooned out this past weekend. I don't know why, but it's what it is.
Try helping him. I tell him how to stand up. Like, dude, get this. He comes back after a quarter of a lap. It's not comfortable. The cockpit is this and that. Okay, so
but
now.
It got
now,
better, though.
And then I told him, dude, what about this? And I go, put your head up. He's looking down at the front number plate.
Nice.
Yeah, supposed to look ahead. He looks at the front number plate. Maybe the front tire that he likes so much. And then I tell him, dude, look up. A little more, now there's more room.
But he, I have to move my bars, though.
He listens to Kiefer all the time. Kiefer testing. Oh, they told me to do this. Okay?
So true.
But now he has tuck butt, and he's riding like a goon. Kiefer don't teach goon riding, dude.
No, he doesn't.
MX Factory, they don't teach goon riding.
Nope.
Rhino? Anyways. Rhino's my buddy, too. Anyways, he's just all tuck butted. So he looks weird. So then we move his handlebar, Jord. This much, everybody.
But it made a big difference.
This much. Oh, it feels great now. I have so much room in the cockpit.
Yeah, I did. It was weird, man. I'm telling you, it felt like this tiny little triangle. I don't know, it was fucking weird.
Mental.
This, yes. Oh, this guy is very this. Oh, my God.
Hey, it felt good. It felt much better afterwards, dude.
He still only rode a half lap. So I don't know if it felt good or not.
I do know it felt better. Dude, just wait. I'm going to go in the hell. It's going to be on. There can be no tuck butt out there.
Okay.
I'm serious.
Okay.
No tuck butt. Sending it.
Oh, you could put... That could be a story.
What?
Snapchat story. Tuck butt? Instagram story.
Tuck butt?
Yeah.
No, not a tuck butt. You're not going to have an image of it.
Okay, I hope not. Because we're recording. I'm going to put a GoPro on. It's going to be hard to stay behind you. It's going to be hard to stay behind you.
It's going to be hard to stay...
I'm going to try really hard to stay behind you.
You're going to
be hard to stay behind you, but we'll record it.
All right.
I'm going to have to go like this, then stop and look like this, and then go.
That's
and
fine.
Stop
or stand on the side of the fence.
The best part is you get both angles. You get the front and the back.
Yeah. You know, I need a 360 front. Camera.
That'd be cool. You need a 360 camera, yeah.
Yes, I can get
it. So you get me, Fred, and everybody else.
Yeah. Yes.
I'll allow it.
I should just be a drone. That way I can just be up here on top and see you guys, because that half a second that I see you, it's not really working.
So go by and do your thing, and everybody else is doing their thing.
Talking mad crap. I'm going to love it.
I don't talk crap.
Yeah, he does.
I don't talk
crap. You're a big shit talker.
I don't talk shit.
I don't talk shit. I try to say things like, keep it cool.
I'm just throwing facts out there. Facts.
I didn't deny it. I was definitely talked about this past weekend, but also you being nervous. It's a long way.
Who are you showing up for?
Wait, you know what the funniest part about this whole thing? We go to the track, and we've never been there before. It was cold.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we go to Sandy Valley, and it's... Okay, we had to go through Arizona, through Vegas, or through Nevada to come back to Sandy Valley, because you have to go around and come back in.
Yeah, weird.
So we're there, and we get on the track. And I get dressed. Fred already won his laps, comes back, so I'm going to get on the track. Like, I got dressed, and I'm right about to get on the track. And then Fred goes, okay, come on, let's go. So Fred gets on my first lap. Mm-hmm. I pass Fred. And then my second lap, I left Fred. That was my side lap. And I'm like, Fred, what are you doing? Fred said it was too rough or too bumpy.
Yeah. Fred said it was bumpy.
That his arms got like arm pumped. It was just really cold.
It was cold. Like the first couple hours, I came back and put on a jacket.
I'm lucky my feet didn't go cold.
But yeah, that's when you're done.
But I had actually the little warming pads. Mm-hmm. I was going to put some in my boots. And that would have been good. Because my toes get cold, I'm done. Game over.
So that's your stop zone? No.
Oh, yeah. No, dude.
My hands were hurting
actually,
so bad.
Actually, if his socks are wet, the day's ruined.
Yeah. Oh, I understand that. Yeah. I kind of agree with him.
Yeah, mm-hmm. No soggy socks. No soggy feet.
It doesn't. Mm-mm.
Soggies don't work. Yeah, we're good with soggy feet.
I am, too. I understand completely.
You feel a squish?
Oh, we're done.
Yeah,
which is kind of hard because if I put the plastic bags on when it's cold and you put the plastic bag in your foot, because mm-hmm. you put the plastic bag over and it keeps your foot insulated because it keeps it warmer, mm-hmm. your foot gets wet. Mm-hmm. So every once in a while you'll feel the squishy. Mm-hmm. And if I feel that squishy, it's just not comfortable no more. Mm-hmm. I did it before riding and I had to stop. Chain socks. Start over. And to change my socks out riding, I have to take off like a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Not very funny. That's not funny at all. So, I don't know. What are you looking at, Dave? What are you looking at?
I get zoned out right now.
Zoned out?
Yeah, I zoned out right now. Because I looked at the body sport ball that's down there.
Want to work out?
Nope.
No, sure.
I don't want to go to sleep.
I did that for like 10 seconds.
Jordan worked out last time he was here.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
Jordan got a quick... repping with that. What'd you rep with? The ball. Yeah, the ball. He lifted up and put it down about 10 times. 10 or 3 times.
That's all he got?
About 10 or 3 times. No, that's a lot of workout for him.
Mm-hmm. Remember, I don't leave my room.
What?
Yeah, I don't go outside.
He plays games in his room. His work's in his room. His office is in his room.
Huh?
Only time he leaves his room is to go to the front door to pick up food.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, you don't even go and get your own food, huh?
Yeah, he does. He goes to the front door.
Yeah.
That's a walk, dude. That's a hike. That's like loading up the wagons. Preparing.
All right, guys. I got to get ready and adjust. Where are you going? To the front door.
You guys get there before Jimmy. Jimmy will throw it away.
Oh. Yeah, he will. He would throw it away.
Really?
Yeah, there's no leftovers in that household. That household, as soon as anything's in there, the hell is this shit doing here? Throw us away.
Oh, wow.
Yep.
Yeah, ruthless.
Mm-hmm.
Say I was criminal.
Hmm?
Oh, nothing.
Security.
That was a sound. So, when we're going to... What did we talk about when we went to... You know what? We're going to have to do this for another podcast, because I think... Yeah, I have another podcast we were talking about on the way to Sandy Valley. We should do that one next. Because we had some good subjects on there. What about the accident that just ruined everything?
Yeah, right? That was fucking crazy.
Wait, what accident?
We're driving back, so we're right leaving Baker after getting sandwiches, and we get onto the 15 heading southbound. And as soon as we get outside the city, we pass a cop who's sitting there on the right-hand side. And we're going, and we see traffic kind of slowing down. Tim's like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah, like, why are they stopping?
That's exactly what he said. I'm like, I don't know. I don't even see it because there's a big rig kind of... Over here is like two big rigs, and then
they're going slow. They're going slow, mm-hmm. and then there's cars on the side, and I'm like, "Oh, somebody flipped over."
That's what he said. Yeah.
But why is everybody slowing up? Like they're stopping. Like stopping.
Here's the thing, though. There was no at that time. There was no paramedics there. No, it just happened. There was no cop cruiser. So as we're driving by, Tim's looking forward. He's all like, probably glanced over. There's a bunch of debris on, like, grocery debris on the freeway, mm-hmm. or highway rather. And I look over to the right, and I see the lady talking to the old dude who's like, or a gentleman who's like slumped over the seat like this, and it's like not responsive. And mm-hmm. I was like, what the fuck? And seeing like the whole windshield like.
Yeah, it was like this. Dude, it was in that triangle like this.
Yeah.
Like, they rolled
crazy. Mm. I was so wondering how it happened.
Then I see that, I look in the mirror and I see that CHP light. So he's coming up and catch. So we're right at the thing. So he pulls right behind us. And then he pulls up and then traffic's still going slow because people are like looking this way.
Yeah,
like, stop Snapchatting. Let's go. We don't need this on a story, dude. Let's go.
And then all y'all coming back through Victorville. I don't know what going on
there. down the Cullen Pass. It's a downhill, and we're going like we're stopping, putting the brakes on. It's a downhill. Let's go. Let's roll. Roll with it.
Yeah.
Lean with the rock with it. Let's go, dude. Like, seriously.
But there were so many people coming into the town, dude. I thought they would all be leaving town for Christmas. That shit was crazy to me.
On Saturday.
Yeah.
George, Saturday traffic.
Heavy
traffic. Oh, there was crazy traffic in L.A.
We weren't in L.A., dude.
We're nowhere near. I know,
but it was. There's traffic all the time everywhere in LA.
It's not fun anymore.
True.
Not fun anymore? Yeah. Was it ever fun?
Yeah. It used to be fun. I remember driving.
Yeah, they had that much traffic. In the 90s.
Yeah. In the 70s, 60s, 50s. I don't know. Whatever I wore, it was fun. We had fun. Not anymore.
I'm kind of jealous of how they had it with like the 80s and early 90s or mid 90s to 2000s, like at the beginning. Pretty much.
How was 90s. It? How was it?
No, I'm saying for you guys being an adult and being able to enjoy it, like going riding and shit like that. I don't know how it was. I was a child. That's what I'm getting at. The stories I hear about you guys just being able to go someplace and go riding.
They could have been lying though, because you weren't there. You weren't there. You don't know what they're saying.
So true. Actually, it never happened.
Yeah,
it did happen because there was a track right over here. Across on the side of Peck Road. That's what they want. That people rode at.
That's just what they want. I went there
on my bicycle.
Oh, see, okay. He rode it then.
I saw it.
So that one happened. He wrote. That wrote happened. That's what happened.
We're not going off into you guys' story thingy.
I never saw it, so. I never saw it, so it never really happened.
Shit.
All these stories are just for context.
This guy, dude. There. We're good now? We're good now? Yeah, jeez, this guy.
I need to put it back in there. It's like OCD. It's like, it needs to go in there.
He needs to go in, but he kept like trying to get in.
We
just need to stop.
You just can't get in.
Okay, so we're I forgot what story it was. There's a story we got to talk about next time. And that'll probably be in like another 3-4 months because Dave's not going to come back no more because he...
Who?
You come back?
Yeah, I'm coming back.
Okay, he says he's coming back.
I'm coming back, but I'm not giving you an ETA. That's all I'm saying. I don't know.
No, he's
diva.
Yeah, he's
diva.
Up there.
Like, what, diva? All right, well, next time I want to have sponsored drinks and stuff like that.
You're going to bring us some? You're going to bring us some drinks?
We need a sponsor, yo.
Yeah, he's going to bring us drinks. I was going to feed him today, but, you know, his mom brought him Panda, and that's why he was there.
Yeah.
Panda. We did our thing. He needs to stop. He needs to stop, okay?
Sorry.
Just stop. Stop it. Stop it. All right, everybody. Yep. That was great. It was me, Dave, and Jordan. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. 24 Slayton, like and subscribe. If you like what we did, like. If you like what we did, subscribe. For all you out there, have a great day. I think we'll be back before Christmas. Me and this guy. Hopefully this guy comes back.
Okay? We'll be
back after Christmas. Me.
Why after?
Because we got a lot of things going on. Family and laws.
There's parties. Like, there's other days in that.
And oh, I know. There's something afterwards.
So we could do it. I think we can make it happen.
Well, maybe.
If not, El Nino, we'll make it happen. All right. Thanks, everybody.
Is that on the third El Nino?
Yes. No, there's a lot of El Ninos.
A lot of El Ninos.
Yes.
We got a list.
Yes. They say there's a lot of people that say they want to be on.
Yeah.
And we'll see. Eric is one of them. And Eric, Eric's low key.
We need to get Tom on here.
I think Tom's down. But he's so busy.
Yeah, I know.
And lives so far.
Yeah, true.
He's funny.
That he is.
Yeah, he's funny.
You got a lot of funny friends.
According to some people, me or my friends aren't funny.
That's because they don't get the humor.
No, your mom thinks I'm annoying and So that's your mom, but I'm okay with that. I might be. Yeah, that's what happens. But all right, everybody. I just did my mom. So I did what my mom tells me. Like and subscribe. We're out of here.
Your mom tells you to like and subscribe?
No, my mom, what she says. I better let you go.
Oh, yeah.
And then the story starts again. So like and subscribe, everybody. Hopefully this comes out good. We're working on, I think we're doing a toy drive, me and Jordan. We're going to do a toy drive with some stuff. I think Brian said he has some toys for us. And nice. If you guys have any toys, let me know. 24 Slayton. And then you can email me at info@24slayton.com.
Go on the website.
Go on the website. You can leave a comment.
On the video.
Leave a comment on the bottom.
Don't be shy. Say hello.
Yeah. Jordan wants to hear from you guys.
I do. I asked you for that other, your favorite artist. No one did it.
Oh, no, I got one.
Oh, we did?
I got Temptations. Ooh. And I got Temptations, somebody else. I got a couple of them. I didn't tell you that. Because I didn't want your head to get all big.
My head's already big.
Yeah, that was pretty damn big.
My head's already big.
What are you doing? We're not done yet. We're not done.
You just did your mom thing.
We're not done yet. We're not done. So, once we stop, we're done. But we're still going. Okay? Jeez, this guy.
Unprofessional.
He wants to get it done. He wants to go away so fast.
This is so fast, my ass.
Hey, wait up. You know what? Todd Krieg was here this weekend.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
I didn't get to see him.
He lit you up?
He was doing, was it this weekend? Well, anyways, he was here and he was doing the Disneyland thing.
Disneyland thing.
Shout out to my mom for helping me out and do this again. Yeah, Todd Krieg went to Disneyland. And he went to Disneyland. Didn't come by. He didn't roll through.
Did you hit him up?
Oh, yeah. Too soon. Didn't roll through. yes. Todd Krieg's my boy.
Dude, that's probably going to be like one of my favorite podcasts.
Todd Krieg?
Yeah.
But he has to be here, though. I have to fly. I'm serious. I have to fly him out for that one. Somehow I have to get Todd Krieg. Move that and put him right there, dude.
We don't have any chair for him.
He's got his own.
Yeah.
He's good. He brings his own shit.
Yeah.
He don't mess around.
Dude, that would be the best podcast. That's going to be one
that
of the
would
best
be. Podcasts. I could do 5 hours of Todd Krieg.
Really? Seriously,
I could. Yeah. Me and Todd just go.
I feel like you could also do probably 5 hours of Robert.
Yes, I could. Yeah. I could probably do 5 hours of Jordan.
We have.
Okay. I could probably do 3.5 hours with David. Three hours with David. Black David.
Yep. Fat and drinks, and we got in two with Fat David.
Hey, when's what's saying coming back?
Who? David?
No.
No. Your boy that came before.
Oh, I need to ask him. I have not. I asked him if he said he's down to come back on. He just finished moving.
Does he watch the podcast?
Does he watch it all the time? I haven't asked him.
Yeah, we got to talk to him. He's got to come here and be on again.
Yeah. I'll message him because I'll talk to him tonight.
Beto.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, Beto.
And you guys can get into your nerd stuff. You guys can go for hours with
nerd you guys talk. Probably nerd up.
Well, like, more so than me.
You know what I have? I want him to come because I have those.
Oh,
I got two of them. I got two of them for that. Just
was talking about Funko.
Just Pop. Because he doesn't like Funko, I got two of them. I might have three by the time he comes back, just because. I don't even like them. But you know what? I do like them because that one is Jerry Seinfeld.
Uh-huh.
It's only at Target. But it can't. How could it be only at Target when it's right there?
See, he has insight into that.
How could it be only at Target, but it's right there?
Because you bought it from Target.
Only at Target. It's right there.
And that's also not true. You can buy it at Frankenstein's.
It's right there.
Okay.
So how's it only at Target if it's right there?
Because you bought it. You purchased at a store. You can only buy it at Target.
It doesn't say. It says only at Target.
Oh, well, that's too literal. In a literal sense. Where's the other one?
Literally, it says that. And then I have no soup for you. I have the
Soup Nazi.
I have them.
Oh, so you made another Funko of that too?
Yes. I have the Funko. Hold on. Hold on, everybody.
Great commercial.
Casey. I got him. Okay, there.
How many more of those things are there?
What? Probably a lot of them. But we got this guy. Like, because I could do this again. Chork. Mm-hmm. No soup for you.
Wow. Moody.
No soup for you. Soup Nazi. So when you watch it, if you do watch it, this one's funny.
No, that is a good episode.
No soup for you. All right? All right, buddy. We're out. You good? Yeah.